Hello, everybody.
It is our day.
Episode 200.
Cracking a cold on for that.
Already drunk.
200 episodes are now through. That's pretty crazy.
It is. I joined you on episode 6.
Yeah. Pretty much,
I joined you on episode 6.
You've been there since day one.
Well, may I just say...
Give me your praise, bro.
I'll just say before this, the podcast isn't here without the man to my left here.
It's not here to the man with my right.
No, it's... This is the mastermind. I just turn up every week. So...
I think he's forgetting who does all the TikTok. I'm not... all right, maybe I'm the man. No, I'm joking. No, it's true. Let's be honest. The fight rundown would not be at 200 episodes if it weren't for both of us.
Well, you know we've both stuck to it, haven't we?
Yeah.
There's constant, we've had so many backouts from guests, for example.
Yeah.
Obviously not naming any names, but it's
lost
just...
Lost a lot of money.
We've lost a lot of money. It's been... Oh, get to mine quick. It's going to happen. We're about to film something. Oh, all of a sudden, no, nothing. No answer. Yep. But we've had to keep going. We've had to
Sunday
adapt.
At 8 a.m. time. Saturday at 8 a.m. Saturday at 8 a.m.
We've had to adapt, haven't we, at times. And wouldn't change any of it, mate.
No, not for sure. I mean, we might as well. This episode is going to be about the fire rundown. You know what I mean? It's going to be one for the boys and girls. But yeah, it's true. Like, realistically, would I be 100 episodes in if I wasn't with you? No. Would you be able to do the podcast without myself for 200 episodes? No.
It's
not going to
exactly
answer for
that.
You, but it's true, isn't it?
It's exactly that. Yeah.
We can't do it without one of each other. I feel like, I mean, should we just have some negatives of the fire rundown?
Go on then.
It has been an absolute burden on the life, hasn't it?
Like, it has been, yeah.
Some days you don't want to do it. Some days.
Yeah.
But then you know you got to come in. You got to review the episode, even if no one's going to listen.
Yeah, and it was tough, wasn't it? With like, you know,
should we start at the early days?
Yeah,
I'll get the Instagram open so we can get like some of the milestone episodes, maybe.
Yeah, and I'm telling you, we did that 100 episode origins episode. Sorry.
Whoa.
We did that episode not long ago. It wasn't that long ago.
It was about 15 months ago, but it's crazy. It was in April, wasn't it? March, April time last year.
We've done so much in that time as well.
It's ridiculous, yeah. Try not to look now, because obviously we're like doing everything we've done, but...
Yeah.
Like, all, yeah, 100, the 100th episode was only got about... a cumulative 130 views, which, I mean, cumulatively is more than our YouTube sometimes, but also we get, obviously our biggest audience is Spotify now by a long margin. Yeah. The thing is, we're not bothered about talking about the numbers. Some people are dead anal about it, aren't they?
Yeah, but, they are.
I mean, we're hitting probably around 300-400 listeners, maybe 500 listeners per episode. Between three to 550 is what we say.
And it's gone up in the last year massively, hasn't it?
Yeah, yeah. It was hitting 100 last year, kind of all together. But obviously, episode 100, big name. It was kind of, people tuned in a bit more.
Yeah.
We're not bothered. We know we don't smash insane numbers.
We're far off making it a living still.
Yeah.
Basically.
But also... I think there's enough to carry on.
Oh, 100%. Yeah, we've definitely seen enough.
Should we start at that bit? Should we start at that bit? Like, I remember, where was the first? Here it is. Episode 5 was the first episode with bowls.
Wow.
So let me just read the description of this episode. Episode 5 is out now. This one was fun to record. Harry Bowles joined myself to talk about the UFC 2021 awards, speaking on some of the favorite moments from the year. With some dream scenario fire rundown questions to listen, go to Apple, Spotify, or click the bio. And then look at that thumbnail. It's crazy, isn't it? How far we've come.
It's not awful, is it? But...
Compared to now, it tells you what's going to be on the episode. It does tell you what's going to be on the episode, maybe better than what we do now.
Yeah, it probably does, but who needs that? You know, you want the clickbait.
That's it, yeah. And we got 3 likes.
Yeah.
On the post, shout out. Shout out to one of them was Bowles.
Yeah, of course it was.
Other was Mum and Dad. And shout out George Hewitt.
Yeah.
Shout out George Hewitt. So
lifelong listener right there.
Possibly. I think he is.
Yeah.
I know we can't tell he listens, but yeah, then before that, we're not gonna talk about before that too much, but it was pretty washed. I mean, Combat Thoughts came on a couple times. All About Balance pod. They were pretty good. He was a good co-host. And then, yeah, and then pretty much from episode 5 onwards. Of course, there's a few ups and downs between me and Bowles in terms of, do we stick it out? And
oh, then, yeah. I think I didn't want to come back after episode 5 for a bit. But I did. I don't know. I don't know why.
This happened. This is the exact thing that happened to keep you on.
Yeah.
Bowles got a Fire and Down hoodie.
Yeah, exactly.
The first
yeah.
ever Mayor's drop.
Yeah.
Kind of legendary. We're just going to, by the way, we're just flicking through our Instagram. Just going to go through some big moments in the Fire Rundown.
It's a great hoodie.
It is a good hoodie, yeah. It's legendary, that hoodie. Mm. Unfortunately, do we re-release them ever?
No.
Do you not
these
think?
Are, these ones are special. Yeah. Yeah.
I need mine reprinted. I need a fresh one.
I need a new one as well. I've got a paint. I took it to work once. I've got a paint stain here, and it's pissed me off ever since.
Oh. That's fucking illegal.
It is. And so, yeah, we definitely need to get one each.
Yeah. We'll get a re-up.
Yeah, I'll tell you what we need. We need a bunch of shit, both of us. Like, loads of different stuff.
Yeah. Let's put an order together. Yeah. Not today, because after commitments. After
yes.
commitments.
Yes.
But we'll get that ordered. But then, from there, so pretty much in the last 180 episodes, it's been a partnership, hasn't it? It's been a full-on.
Yeah.
Well, 190 episodes, it's been a full-on, let's lock in together every episode. But yeah, let's just scroll up to a the second ever drop, the mugshots.
The mugshots are great.
Legendary drop right there, isn't it?
Yeah. Still wear the Mike Tyson one, obviously. That was my favourite one.
Still see the Mike Tyson about as well.
Yeah, it's the one that I've got the most comments from. Or like if I remember, like, for example, when I used to go to a barber's.
Yeah.
Used to go to the barber's and be like, oh, that's a nice top. I was like, oh, well, actually, we do them ourselves. You know what I mean?
That was the best feeling, wasn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah, it was.
I got compliments in Turkey and Tenerife.
Wow.
I mean, a lot of people would come up to me. It's a great talking point, is it?
It's a flipping great promo vid as well.
Thing is, one thing that's never lost is not only the banter. The banter's always stayed.
It has.
That's why me and Bowles are together, because, well, together on the pod. You know what I mean? It's not a bit gay there. But the point I'm making is the banter's always stayed, and the editing's always been high class.
It has, and... Yeah, the quality of the videos, no matter how many views they get, like, the vlog that we've just put out isn't got great views, but...
It's not.
We're going to keep with the editing, and we're going to keep with the good quality, because one day, it's going to matter.
By the way, we could fuck ourselves massively if we blow up, because of the amount of copyright music we put in. Like, but we do it for you.
Yeah, stay
it. We do it for you. We want to be, like, the Nelk type.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Constantly just put the bangers on. Just enjoy it. Just enjoy it, as Rio Ferdinand says.
Do you remember, I was speaking about, you know, like the promo vid there. Do you remember when we tried to film a promo vid, like, in the woods or something?
Oh, I watched it. Did we put it out? Yeah, we posted it, yeah. We'll get to it just after this, but let's have a look. There was a nice little TikTok, I think. Just of all, some of the legendary clothes.
It's sick, that.
This is when I was jobless, so it was very much Fire Rundown grind.
Yeah.
That's when we released the Canelo hoodies. That one went down really well as well.
A great hoodie again.
But then if we look at the beginning, the stats from the end of 2022, we had top podcast for 18 people. So roughly around 130 people were in the list. Top episode of the year. Your questions asked. That was a good episode.
It was.
I think that's when we did favourite entrances. And I picked CM Punk and you picked... we posted it. I can't remember. Let me check. There, what would your walkout song be if you had one? So I picked Punk.
Oh, Jimmy Cooks, I bet.
Yeah, it was, yeah.
Wouldn't be now. Good song still, though. I still...
Yeah, I'm not a massive fan of it, but... But then, of course, the advent calendar, the first ever advent calendar. And then, where's the new season? I literally watched it the other day. That's pretty annoying. Or was this done after?
Pretty sure.
It must have been after this.
Yeah, it was.
I thought it was beginning of the year, to be fair. But yeah, we did the advent calendar, and then obviously go into a new year. I remember the first... Oh, there it is. This is a... I'll put it on the screen. Maybe this is the only bad edit Jeeves ever done. Taking a shot at one of our friends here. This is a proper plowy edit.
Yeah, right, it actually is.
So, guys, welcome to the
Fire
Rundown Season 2.
Hey! It's kind of a banger.
It is good.
It's kind of a banger, little lad. And then, yeah, we went into the new year. Of course, some say we peaked here.
Yad Beterbiev.
Yeah, Yad Beterbiev. The day... Oh, what a day. I mean...
Met the man himself.
Yeah, met
just Anthony chilling, Mark. just getting some Adidas clobber. I mean, do you reckon, because he's sponsored by Adidas, isn't he?
Yeah.
Do you reckon he just gets like a black card where he can just get whatever he wants? Do you reckon that's part of his deal?
Not a black card, no. I reckon the only person who has a black card is Messi.
Do you reckon?
Yeah. Like, I don't know, yeah, probably just Messi.
Do you reckon? Hmm.
But yeah, this picture, legendary. I mean, I remember we got 44 likes. I was going crazy.
Yeah, innit? Yeah.
I was like, I don't think we even had 44 followers. You know what I mean, it was like,
this is what
we probably did.
I think we had like 70.
Yeah, we did. No, to be fair, it's one thing that was good when Balls come on board. He brought a lot of the followership in. I mean, that was one of his quotas, one of his KPIs, one of his targets was to bring the followers in. He did. It was, but the fits were legendary. Let's just zoom in on some
of the fits. It's a
good fit. It is a good fit. Yeah. Does it stand the test of time? I'm going to say no. You've got a crew neck and a track jacket. I don't think you'd be caught doing that now.
No, I absolutely wouldn't. And I feel like I've lost a little bit of timber from that point as well.
Yeah, you know what? You do look large there. But Yard low-key underrated drip.
Yeah,
he had a fit on and he had the easy shoes with him.
Yeah. And right.
Let's not talk about my shoes.
Your drip.
Yeah, the drip was like, so, you know what? If you was ever to meet a boxer, this is the fit you'd wear.
Yeah.
Don't forget, this was unplanned. I had Armani jeans, Converse, an Apple Watch.
Fight run down.
And a fight run down hoodie. And by the way, I've definitely lost weight since this picture.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
I reckon I was, you can see the bags on my eyes. Yeah. I reckon I was 10... Thing is, I remember 109. No, I remember I was actually proud here because I thought I'd slim down, but I was like 106. So that's not good. That's not good.
I was probably about 100 there.
You reckon?
102 maybe, somewhere like that.
But yeah, what a night! What a night that was. And then
24 hours in London vlog, incredible.
Watch the vlog. And then Levi comes on first time. I mean,
blows up the page a little bit, doesn't it?
Yeah, that was a bit of a takeoff, wasn't it?
It was, yeah. I mean, it's why, like, when I mentioned, like, the guests that always fail to come on and stuff, it's why you got to give so much credit to people like Levi, who are repeated guests, who always come on and always support. I mean, it's...
Yeah.
It's so nice, isn't it?
Yeah, it's nice. And we've got a good connection there. David Benavidez.
Strangest episode ever.
Yeah, it was. It literally came up, like, I can do it now. Like, right now, and that's it. And I had my mate round. I had a good mate, Brandon, round. And I said, we were watching wrestling. I was like, yo, I've got to go to work. And at this point, it was where Fight Run Down. It was all right. Doing all right. It was good enough to continue, kind of.
Yeah.
I remember I text Balls. I think he was out.
I was at work.
Yeah, you was at Jug and Bottle, weren't you?
Yeah, I was working at a pub at the time.
Yeah, so I remember I did the episode. The quality's terrible. And also, David Benavidez bought likes on our post.
Yeah, he did, yeah.
So, very weird. But it is like, technically our most liked post. And then, Coley Light. I mean...
Incredible interview with David Light.
This picture just screams all sorts of wrong.
Oh, God.
So, yeah, we went to the... Of course, this is a bit of an age-old story, but we've grown a lot since then. We go to the event, the weigh-ins for Coley Light, and of course Levi versus Gomez. The vlog says it all. Watch the vlog if you really want to get into it. But our first, we needed an interview. Was like, we've got to get one. But yeah, I was low-key, kind of bricking it. He was.
Absolutely.
You was. You did, like, not trying to out you here, but.
No, I was.
I had to go and make the move, didn't you?
Like, yeah, too scared.
So we go up to David, like, on his own with, like, this girl, I'm guessing is, and his mate. And it looks like his some mate and the other girl was mates.
Yeah. And I'm not lying, it was a, like, 1:20 interview.
Oh, man. Yeah, it was the shortest episode ever.
It's bad.
It's the shortest podcast. It's really bad. It's only on Apple Podcasts and Spotify. But yeah. It's really deep down. It's going to be hard to find, isn't it?
It's going to take me too long. I was going to try to find it.
For that.
Episode no in the 80s.
It was absolute... Don't. No, don't. If they want to listen, I can find it. It was the worst episode ever.
Yeah.
But we also got a lot of confidence from that, didn't we?
We did, yeah. And it was almost a bit of a catalyst, wasn't it?
It loosened us up, even though it was that bad.
Callum Simpson loosened us up for sure.
Yeah, yeah, 100%. That was a great one. Matt Loki burnt through the T-shirt, though. We're so happy that we spoke to the box. Gave Callum Simpson a fire run down top. Probably should have given it to Fraz Clark.
Oh, definitely should have, yeah.
We're so annoyed with him. and then, we did one with Fraz Clark. The start of one of the greatest relationships in sports history. Like, you talk about Turkish, Frank Warren and Eddie Earn. You're putting the fire run down in Fraser Clark's partnership.
Oh, absolutely, yeah. And, you know, didn't he say... to you when you saw him, where's my bald brother at? Or something.
Yeah. He was, what did he say?
He knows us both, though.
Yeah. Well, what did he say? So he couldn't get into a GBM show, and I was working it for ESBR. Shout out ESBR.
Wait, Fraz couldn't get in?
Yeah, do you not know this?
I can't remember you saying that.
Yeah, so I had to, basically, there was no service inside the show.
Yeah.
So I had to go and stand night. At the back of VIP, outside, where all the VIP and boxers parked. So I went there to, like, upload the video or send it through. And Fraz Clark's like, no, I just want to get in. I was like, we can't let you in because you're not on the list. Oh. And I remember I just walked past. I heard that. I went, you're right, Fraz, how's it going? So I dapped him up. Like, big old dap, good connection.
Was it good?
Well. Yeah. And I go, well, how's it going? He goes, nah, pretty shit. They're not letting me in. I just turned to the guy and said, how are you not letting Fraz Clark in? Literally 3 weeks ago, one of the biggest tear-ups of all time.
Yeah.
And it ended up getting sorted. I said, oh, we're getting a bit of time late. He was like, yeah. He says, oh, where's your bald brother? Where's your bald brother? And I was like, oh, I'm doing it for someone else today. He was like, ah. I said, oh, don't worry. We'll get a little clip for the fire rundown. He goes, ah, good lads. And he said, I'll see you in a bit. He said, I'll definitely do you lot. And then also he did. He held his word. Similar to Levi.
Yeah. He did very good man, isn't he? And you get it a lot with Fraser Clark as well. It's what you hear. He's a genuine good lad.
He told someone to shut the fuck up as well. Because he was doing an interview. And then there was these two people, not going to out him, but they were chatting. And he turned around and he goes, can you shut the fuck up, please?
Wow.
Then he apologised. He felt so bad, but...
He's a good man. Isn't he? That's he's not got like some balls Fraser. On him. No. That's not like Fraser. Good picture, that, by the way.
Yeah, this is a.
I'm looking the worst there for sure.
Yeah, it was night two of WrestleMania, so I had the Bloodline T-shirt. Yeah, and I was repping.
I'm not looking great there, but you two are looking beautiful.
Levi looks so awkward in that picture. And then, of course, we're just going through the vlog. Obviously, the vlog was legendary.
Fucking hell, yeah, and vlog was great.
That is the best vlog. That is the best vlog.
It is, yeah. Enjoyable vlog.
I mean, I was fat there as well. You know, I was. I reckon it was probably 103,
dead
104.
Trim.
I don't know. Jag was watching the vlogs. He's like, Bowles might look younger with hair. It was like, only when it was fresh.
Yeah. Yeah. Muay Thai Grand Prix.
Legendary event. Pretty legendary. It was a long day, wasn't it?
Yeah, 10-hour day there.
And then obviously episode 100. So 100 episodes ago was 21st of May, 2023. Jesus. And all we did was just talk about what we're talking about now.
Pretty much.
Signed Joe Orton on episode 99.
Yeah.
First ever fight rundown signed fighter. That was pretty sick. Even meeting people like Max Barnett. Yeah, you know I mean, would I?
What a man.
Would I meet him through anything else? Probably not.
Yeah. And he's part of the team now, really, isn't he?
He is, yeah. He's similar to Levi, you know what I mean? Yeah. Just within the team.
The circle.
And then Bowles' first breakout, I'd say.
Yeah, first ever interview, really, with a
solo
huge name. Yeah. With a huge name of Maxie Hughes, who is a little bit famous, isn't he, now?
Huge name, yeah.
He is famous, isn't he, at the moment. Probably beat Kambosos, but, you know.
Yeah, yeah. I mean,
it is what it is.
Civil War, of course, when we stroke war on Bob Arum and Liam Smith. that feature is goated, isn't it?
We're looking. I'm looking good there. That's a fresh.
You are Solo Sikoa. I'm Roman Reigns in that picture. Then what else? I mean, Joe wins a title. We sign the IR in the same weekend.
What
that's
a weekend.
That's pretty nuts.
See Max again.
Yeah, James Richardson on the pod.
Yeah. Dex Spellman. A little bit of a... I know we did a guest week at one point, didn't we? Which didn't actually...
It ended up going down pretty well. Yeah. I'll try and find guest week. Oh, then we go into the end of the year for the year of 2023. Look at this. From the year before, we had plus 238% listeners, plus 317% streams, plus 204% followers. And we created almost double the minutes.
Yeah.
Well, almost a double and a half the minutes. Like,
it just gives you an incentive to just grind it out more the next year, doesn't it?
And that was before the Christmas calendar.
Yeah.
And of course, the Christmas calendar, always brutal, but we don't complain.
No. Nope.
Announced, wow. Announced our 5K.
We have the biggest announcement.
It is.
Fire Rundown
history. It was,
and it still is.
Yeah, of course, the charity Fight Rundown 5K. It was a monumental moment for us. It was hard work. Oh, and we also went on a guest podcast.
Yeah, we was guests on a podcast also, weren't we?
Yeah. But yeah, then we had... where was the Fight Rundown? Well, let's look at the Fight Rundown 5K further up. But we did have guest week. Kicked off...
Big guests on the guest week, wasn't there?
It did. It kicked off with Levi Giles. Kicked off with Troy Williamson, actually.
Troy Williamson, yeah. Troy Williamson was one where you wasn't about, I don't think. Or was you?
This one was 100% you. I was like, wedding.
I had to bike to your house and get the Mac.
You picked the stuff up on Friday.
Yeah, got the Mac.
And then you did it on Sunday.
I had to learn how to use Zoom.
yeah, you did, actually. Yeah,
that was... But I mean, Troy Williamson, great bloke, just a little bit...
awkward on.
Awkward. But, I mean, I'm not the most...
that Love Island bit.
Yeah, I mean... I'm not the most, what's the word I'm looking for? Flipping egg. I'm not the most confident guy either, you know what I mean? But that was
It ended up
hard.
Being a good episode.
It was a funny episode, Marcus McGee, huge.
Yeah,
huge.
So we had Levi on the Wednesday.
We had Levi, Marcus McGee, who sort of introduced us to the US, really.
Yeah. To be fair, this is probably, it was my dream to have a UFC fighter on. That's why I started the podcast.
Yeah.
It was to get a UFC fighter on. And Marcus McGee, in a couple of years' time, we're going to look back and go, geez, we had him on.
Hopefully one day go to Arizona one day.
Yeah, like you said, he opened a whole new market to us, didn't he?
Exactly, yeah.
It was pretty crazy knowing how big we end up getting. And America's our biggest audience now, so...
Yeah, it's crazy, isn't it?
Have we said much bad about America? Thing is, we do cater to the UK market.
Yeah, I mean, America's growing on me, though.
Yeah. Especially now.
Yeah, especially now.
Yeah. And then we had the Fight Rundown Awards and then the 5K. I mean, this is just legendary, isn't it? This is the greatest achievement of my life.
My life too, yeah.
Like, we did a 5K, we plotted the route, and we raised around 1.5K. I think it was 1.3K to be exact, wasn't it?
It's something crazy, wasn't it? And, we were struggling to get past the 1K mark like the night before, and then all of a sudden, shout out to my girlfriend, the best person I've ever met. So, and she got all of her family to donate, which was incredible.
Yeah, shout out to all the family that donated, all the friends, and also all the pod listeners, you know what I mean? Everyone who tuned in, anyone who donated, we appreciate everyone who joined, but it ended up being just one of the best days, the fact that we got through that, that fact that we had all them people together to go for a run, it's pretty sick.
It is sick.
It was really good, so that was good. And then we had press passes to Kyle Greaves, and we had a couple of them. We had Russ Bray on.
Yeah, Russ Bray.
There's the Fraz Clark clip.
Fraz, what you got to say to Bowles? He was last time, he called you out, the battle with Bowles, and we said you had the best entrance ever. Are you still sticking with that?
Yeah, but you see the last one? That was the one.
We're gonna have to get you one.
Yeah, but you see the last one.
And then, of course, I had the fight. I had my debut fight.
Incredible scenes.
It was. It didn't go.
You brought the crowd.
Ish. That was a small circle.
Yeah,
then,
yeah, it was. You didn't tell anyone about it though, did you?
Just them lot. Yeah, yeah. Just everyone was there. But yeah, had the debut. Didn't win, but also was back. Then, I mean, the TikTok.
Yeah.
Where do we start with that? Obviously, this weekend, the vlog and all the new interviews. David Avanesian, the funniest moment ever.
Yeah.
Funniest moment in Fight Rundown history.
Definitely, yeah. And the TikTok, I won't be surprised if we're hitting a million views now.
Jesus. Yeah, I don't have my phone. I'll check on my phone later. It's crazy numbers, isn't it?
It is.
And that was all balls. That's all balls. Give him this.
I appreciate it. I'm absolutely begging to hit 1,000 followers.
Yeah.
As I said previously, because I just want to go live. I want to be able to interact with people. I want to be able to put polls on there. Who wins what? I want to have discussions on there. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
There's on live, and it's just a great way to interact. And you know, it's just something I've always wanted to do. So please follow the TikTok.
Well, I think we've covered everything there.
100%.
This is only 200. We're going to be back here for another 250. We're going back for 1,000. Yeah, I mean,
1,000.
It's going to keep going up.
It's going to get to the point where we can't even put numbers on them anymore.
That's it. You know, yeah, we're going to start separating them. We're going to have to do UFC episodes, boxing episodes, personal episodes.
Yeah.
But most importantly, we thank you for all the support. We appreciate everyone who's tuned in. Especially, you know what? We're going to show off to Spotify. Shout out to everyone who actually listens to Spotify.
Yeah, the real cheese in Spotify.
Yeah, the Spotify and the Apple podcast, we appreciate. You can follow us on Instagram, TikTok, X, YouTube, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, wherever you get your podcast from, at The Fight Rundown. I'm Jeeve.
Bowles.
And we will see you soon.
Gonna have to get back.